Good morning. Myself Arun, Assistant Professor of Anna University Regional Campus, Madurai, Tamil Nadu. Today we are going to talk about that crosstalk. What is crosstalk? It is the effect of other signals on the desired signals. That means, in the optical fiber cable, it contains multiple channels and multiple signals traveling in the different directions, in the forward direction and the backward direction. Also, the optical fiber cable is communicating in the way of WDM, wavelength division multiplexing. That means lot of wavelengths are divided and multiplexed and traveled, transmitted and received in the single optical fiber cable. So there is lot of possibilities in the crosstalk. In crosstalk occurs not only in the multiplexer, it also occurs in the demultiplexers, filters, switches, and in amplifiers. There are two types of crosstalks. One is interchannel crosstalk, another one is the intra-channel crosstalk. When the crosstalk signal is at the same wavelength, then it termed as intra-channel crosstalk. The difference is within the receiver's electrical bandwidth. It is also called coherent crosstalk. It arises due to the reflections in transmission link. Example, arises when the cascading wavelength demux with wavelength multiplexer. Both signals have same data but not in the phase. Another example is the crosstalk arising from optical switches also. It is due to the non-ideal isolation of one switch port from another. Here signal contains different data. The crosstalk penalty is high when the state of polarization of crosstalk signal is same as that of desired signal, when the crosstalk signal is exactly out of phase. Interchannel crosstalk, when the crosstalk signal is at different wavelength from that, this is termed as interchannel crosstalk. The difference is larger than the receiver's electrical bandwidth. Example, gain of one channel affected by other channel. Here in this diagram, it shows the crosstalks occurs in demultiplexer and also in optical switches, filters. Crosstalk in networks. When signal propagates through many nodes, crosstalk gets accumulated due to different elements at each node. Examples, it occurs in the multiplexers, demultiplexers and in the end switches. This crosstalk suppression becomes important in networks. Bidirectional system. In this, data is transmitted in both directions over a single fiber. Here the lambda I and the lambda j shows the forward direction and backward direction of the wavelength respectively. The laws of physics do not prevent the same wavelength being transmitted in both directions. This leads to additional crosstalk. The main reason is due to back reflections. Can be avoided using different wavelengths. Crosstalk reduction. Crosstalk should be suppressed at the device level itself. The various approaches are spatial dilation, wavelength dilation, addition of filters for each wavelength. Spatial dilation. In this diagram, it shows the 2x2 switch and also the 2x2 dilated switch. Demerit of this system is number of switches get doubled. Sometimes it uses only one switches. The other three switches must be in ideal condition. Wavelength dilation. This diagram shows the wavelength dilation used when single switch is used for multiple wavelength. It increases the channel spacing. Demerit, number of switches gets doubled. Here also it's the problem. Cascaded filters. When filters are cascaded, then the overall pass band is smaller than individual pass band. When the center frequency are not identical, then it results in loss and crosstalk. That's enough.